So I'm John Lansdell from the bada team, and the things that we're involved in are producing technical resources for which makes things easier for existing bada developers and also anybody who's coming over to the bada platform. So things like the videos, the recipes, the code samples, the bada book. And one of the things that I did before coming to Samson, I spent 2 years in the as a trainer in the Symbian technical training team. And the idea but this is, no matter what smartphone platform you've been developing for, there's going to be a lot of ideas in bada that are going to be familiar to you. So you're not starting with a blank slate. They're going to be things like, well, when we talk about bada, we talk about the fact that it's C++ as the native language. We have well-organized APIs that make it very easy for you to find what you want and also to map it to what you're familiar with before. Everything is asynchronous, we'll talk about that. We'll talk about alternatives to C++, and that's Flash and web development. And we've got a bit of standard technologies, so stuff you'll be familiar with, like with OpenGL and other technologies that you'll need to have on the platform. And we'll also be talking a bit about how the network security in bada matches up to other development environments that you're used to. So, bada is written in C++. You write your native applications in C++ as well. And that's great if you're familiar with C++. You don't have to go and learn languages with strange syntax like Objective-C. So, if you've got Symbian C++ background, you'll be familiar with a lot of things in bada. You can, it supports C++ standard template library. It also supports NewLib C library, which is an embedded library for C development. Now, those of you with a Symbian background will be, for when we talk about Symbian development, we talk about everything, the whole layers, right the way from applications, right down to device drivers and libraries and things like that. With bada, it's my kind of platform because it's a third-party application development platform. So we're just talking about apps, we're not talking about anything else. And you might find the IDE familiar. That might be a good thing, it might be a bad thing, because it's based on Eclipse. So if you've done Symbian C++ development, you'll find that it looks very much like Carbide, which was also based on Eclipse. But basically, if you've used just about any other IDE, you're not going to find anything to scare you in the bada IDE. Again, that might depend on whether you like Eclipse, but it's an easy environment to find your way around. So you've got code projects in it, easy to find your way around the various component parts, and it's not something that will confuse you. And one of the most important bits is an idiom that anybody who's done Symbian C++ development will be familiar with and probably groaned when they saw this slide. It's two-phase construction. And what that means, well, bada uses two-phase construction. So why do we do this? The reason we do this, well, one of the reasons is bada does not support standard C++ exceptions. The reason it doesn't support it at the moment is because of runtime efficiency. You can argue whether that's a good thing or a bad thing. That's just the way it is at the moment. So because C++ exceptions are sometimes an issue in mobile, so it doesn't support them. What we do instead is we handle exceptions by checking the return type, return value for functions. And we'll see why that's important in a moment. And we use two-phase construction to prevent memory leaks, and we'll show why memory leaks could occur. So what we have is a separate construct method, and that returns a return result. So let's have a look at it. This is the kind of pattern you'll find in a lot of bada code. Create a new object, and then we call construct. If construct fails, then we call the destructor, we get rid of the object. And then we know that if construct has failed, then everything's got rid of, all the memory has been deallocated. So let's have a look at the problem and then the solution. Basically, we've got a constructor, and within that constructor, we have two data members, which could be arrays, for example. They're complex data members, and we're allocating memory for them. Now, if that fails, we've got no way, because we don't support standard C++ exceptions, we've got no way of knowing that it actually fails. So if we exit it, we could have allocated B1 or B2, and we've got no way to know that we have to delete that. We've got no way to know that we maybe didn't have enough memory to create that whole object fully. So that's a problem. It's a memory leak. And, you know, if you've got a memory leak on a constrained device like a mobile device, that's a big problem. So this is how we resolve it. In the constructor, we just initialize those values to null. And in the construct method, notice that we're returning results. And we're allocating the two data members in the construct method. And if it fails, then we return a result code, and we know that we need to deallocate that memory. So that's the two-phase construction. And that's particularly important even if you've come from another environment. Some people coming to bada will be a bit confused why nothing works. They create their new objects and they start making calls on those objects and they think, well, why does nothing work? That's because they've forgotten to call construct. So most of the bada APIs follow this pattern, but not all. So if you look at a bada class, see if it's got construct in it. If it is, you know you need to call it. That's basically the way you find out. So we've got 21 namespaces. It used to be a very neat 20 namespaces, but there was a new namespace that was introduced in bada 1.1. And because it's organized into 21 namespaces, it's very easy to find your way around. So we've got locations, we've got multimedia, we've got user interface sensors. Once you know your way around the namespaces, it's very easy to find the particular API calls you want. So it's organized in a logical way. Well, we think they're organized in a logical way. Let's have a look. So we've got some of the namespaces here. Application, base, locale, security. These are the basic features. Then we've got user interface type features. UIX is the extended features like face recognition and sensors. That's in the UIX namespace. Finally, we have the service-oriented features. Now, these are the ones that talk about that work with the bada server. So these are features that all have a services component. We've got commerce. We've got location. We've got social. We've got content. Social and locations both have a services sub namespace that contain features that work with the bada server within them. And as I mentioned, these are all in the framework layer. We don't need to know what's going on in this level. We're just concerned about applications. This is just the SDK help, and we're looking at the base class. In the base class, we have numeric types, so we have wrappers for numeric types. We have date time, string classes. String classes is very like, if you've done any Qt development, they're Unicode strings. It's like the QString in Qt. I was going to mention the 16 different descriptor classes in Symbian, since we're doing some comparison to Symbian in this, but nobody else really has that many string classes. So most of the string classes, it's very easy to manipulate strings. We also have, there's a very useful utility class, base subclass, which is utilities, which allows you to parse strings very easily. So really just the thing to say there is, this is just showing you how easy it is to find your way around the bada APIs. Collections, well, you're going to have to deal with if you're doing any code for anything, really. But array list and, the base collections namespace is what implements collections. We have array list and linked list. We have maps, which are key value pairs, queues and stacks, and enumerators to go through the content. So basically anything you could want to do with collections is implemented in bada, and it's done in such a way that you'll be able to find a collection class that's familiar to you, and you should be able to move your code across quite easily. Everything's asynchronous. Well, it is on a mobile phone. You don't want your movie interrupted while you're waiting for the result of a sensor, or you're waiting for something else to happen. There's so many things going on, so many technologies on the mobile phone, so many things that you're waiting for. You don't want to make the user wait for something to return a result. So everything's asynchronous. So what we do is we send